Wonderful show planned for you today.
First, ladies, I'm going to take you in the kitchen and show you how to make the most fabulous Christmas cookies. They just melt in your mouth. Everyone loves them.
I know I sure do. And afterwards, we'll head on outside and we'll show you how to hang your Christmas lights.
That should be easy.
Oh, yeah.
Then we'll take a look at some viewer mail. Good questions this year.
And lastly, guys, this year you've got to give your wife a hand. We're gonna head on out to the shop and I'm gonna give you the nuts and bolts of Christmas wrapping. Yep. This year your wife's gonna love you for this one.
I'm excited about that last one. What do you say? Let's get started.
Let's do.
Hi, here we are in my kitchen. I'm gonna show you how to make those delicious cookies we were talking about earlier. My husband just adores them. First, you need 2 cups of flour, 3/4 cup of cocoa, a teaspoon of baking soda, just a smidge of salt, 1 cup of sugar, 2 eggs, a teaspoon of vanilla extract, and 2.5 cups of butter. Don't forget your peanut butter chips. Mmm. Now let's get our cookie sheet and get started. I seem to have forgotten my cookie sheet. I'm going to have to go to Walmart if we can get one. But don't worry, we'll be right back. Stay with us. Oh! Don't! I'm going to take a trip by the emergency room on the way back. I think I tore a ligament.
If you pack like we did last year, then you won't have any problem finding your lights. They're just right here. Or maybe here. Well, maybe they're here. I know they're in the guest room. Let's go. I know they're in here somewhere. Darn lights. Geez, maybe they're here. Maybe they're in the closet. You know what? Forget it. Let's just go to Walmart and buy some new ones. Darn old lady done lost them again. It looks like the hospital instead of Walmart again.
Back from the hospital already. Don't worry, just a broken leg and a slight concussion. Let's continue our holiday fun by answering a few viewer letters from viewers like you. But first, these messages.
Cat Hunter with Steve Katz. Don't miss the search for the elusive domestic cat.
Those buggers live in strange places. I think I just saw one. I'm gonna go check it out.
Now for some viewer mail. First, Barbara in St. Louis writes, how do I cook dinner for 54 people and still enjoy my holidays? Well, the answer is simple, Barbara. You don't cook. Go to Morrison's and let them do all the work. Our next letter comes from Susie in Cincinnati. Susie writes, my husband is never any help around the holidays. He just watches television and doesn't lift a finger. How can I get my husband to help me out more during the holidays? Well, the answer is simple to that. Go get your husband right now, since he's so good at watching TV. And my husband, who's already well-trained, can show him what he can do to help you out this holiday season. In the meantime, I'm going to be in the kitchen finishing those good Christmas cookies we were talking about earlier with my new pans from Walmart. See you later.
And now it's time for the nuts and bolts of Christmas wrapping. You know, every year, hundreds and possibly thousands of trees are killed to make wrapping paper. Those could be used for more useful items like rod and reels and fishing boats. Instead, we're going to use one of the most abundant and reusable items on the planet. Walmart shopping bags.
Ah.
Yeah, but you can get these anywhere. I bet your wife has a load of these under her cabinet. Just wrap it up so like that. A bow. And your wife's gonna love you like never before, cause you just wrapped a Christmas present. That was the nuts and the bolts of Christmas wrapping.
Honey, my cookies are finally ready. Would you like one?
I've been waiting 7 hours for these. It's so hard to describe the taste.
Didn't I tell you? They're going to love it. Well, that's our show. Join us next week when I show you how to take the contents of any normal garbage can and turn it into this beautiful holiday wreath.
And don't throw away those used toilet paper rolls. Next week, we're going to show you how to make beautiful candle holders.
I have them all over my house. They are beautiful.
Yes, they are.
Well, that's our show. See you next week.